you guys so much for being here. I really want to hear a huge clap for our producer of our show, the woman who brought us all to here together, and a very funny lady. Put on stage!
So I have depression. Took me 10 years to say it out loud. There's just never a good time to be depressed. Couldn't do it when I was a child, because I come from a family that we didn't even say the name of an illness. You know? My brother would come in, because I had a little bit of anxiety, you know? And instead of saying, you know, how's the anxiety going? I mean, I don't think you should say that, happy. You know, instead of saying that, you know, he'd come in and say, how's the going? No. My mom's Middle Eastern, and Middle Eastern moms are really difficult to talk to. You know, they have a physical presence that's like unmistakable about them. You know, she has the MC Hammer balloon pants, a knitted sweater, two scarves wrapped around her head. I come into the room and she's just digging her pants, pulling out a rolling pin, pulling out some duct tape, packing a gum. I'm like, it's Las Vegas in there. You know, I was like 10 or 11 when I kind of thought I was a little too similar to Eeyore. But I couldn't tell anyone. You know, I can't tell a mom. You know, she has the rolling pin in her pants. You know, and a Middle Eastern parent, they're not afraid to use it if you piss them off. You know, so I had to soften the blow a little bit, you know. I wanted to be firm, but I wanted to make it an enjoyable experience. You know, so I put a helmet on. And I walk into the room, I'm like, Mom! And she doesn't turn around. And I'm like, Mom, I have depression. And she's like, what? I'm like, I have depression. And I'm just like in the stance because I'm just waiting for her reaction. And she's like, I have no idea what you're saying. And I can't say depression the third time because I've kind of run out of my confidence at this point. So all I can do is just say, I have. She grabs something and she brings it back and she says, this is going to get rid of all the bad. I'm like, okay. And she hands me an X-lax. Can you shit out the sugar? You know, I see the sugar. Depression, right? And like, you're like, do you experience sadness and loss of interest? I'm like, no. Yeah. They're like, a loss of appetite. And I'm like, never. You know, I was like, you think there's like three symptoms to depression. I'm like, it doesn't manifest like how you think. Right. You know, because there are days where I go and I forget I have depression. I wake up, I'm like, Lord have mercy, I'm finally a regular person. I'm out there doing some regular things, stimulating the economy, even though I'm broke. But I'm handling it. You know? I'm just doing what everybody else does and ignoring the problem. You know, not every day is a bad day, you know? But then suddenly it'd be like 2 o'clock on a Tuesday, you know? And I'm just sitting there relaxing in my apartment, like, just chilling, and all of a sudden I'm like zooming around the house like a cat. And I'm like, oh my God, this match sucks! And I'm like, I only have one black one. Where's the other black one? Like, do I need to make a fire? Like, black sock lost, like, contact owner. And then I'm like, wait, is black socks a fashion faux pas? Like, oh my God, and then suddenly something in the corner of my eye, like, and I look and I'm just like fixated on the wall. And it's like nothing's happening up here, but I can't look away. You know, just like looking at the wall. And how am I supposed to explain that symptom to a doctor that hates cats? like depression is all about management, right? As a depressed person, you know, I should not shop at IKEA. I have the little picture book that are supposed to be instructions, and I'm looking at 70 pieces that are supposed to be my bed, and they all go together with one Allen wrench. And then it's like the fear of like, where did I put the Allen wrench? and then, you know, of course, like everything's fine, you put the bed together and it's good, and then it's like, what if I move? And where did I put the Allen wrench? I also, as a depressed person, I have an Apple Watch. You can't really see it, but this motherfucker is judgmental. Yeah. It doesn't care if you're depressed, if you're passed out, if you're at Grandma Titi's funeral. You're going to get a notification. Looks like you haven't moved in a while. Did we forget how to walk? A snail has a higher heart rate than you right now. It's never enough. Like, I'll be in my apartment, isolating and eating snacks, and I'll get this notification like, you haven't moved in a few hours. Climb some stairs. You'll feel better. Like, bitch, I do. Like, I live in a four-floor walk-up. My gluteus maximus is pumping every day. And who feels better climbing stairs? Those people you see at the gym on the Stairmaster, killing it, all nice. Those aren't New York stairs. Yeah, let me put you on a Stairmaster with a person that just stops on their phone. You know, and a little rat eating a piece of pizza. A ceiling that drips an unidentifiable liquid. Not to a rhythm. Not on a rhythm. You know, let me get some uneven stairs where your leg is like this into your chest. And you got the sketchy pre-war stair where you gotta kind of make sure that motherfucker's safe. You know, the little itty bitty stuff, you know, you gotta like tiptoe on. And then, you know, you got the barrier, and it's not even a step, it's just a barrier placed in front of you. You gotta climb up that thing. Let me see you tackle that. That's all I have for you. Yeah.